Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Tuesday, SpaceX successfully launched their 27th mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 716.
One, ignition, and liftoff of Falcon 9, go Starlink, go SpaceX.
The booster which launched this mission, B1075, then landed successfully for the 10th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
Coming up tomorrow, we can hopefully expect to see another Dragon mission launch. The CRS-30 mission is currently scheduled for tomorrow, Thursday 21st at 8:55pm UTC or 4:55pm EST. The following day, we can also hopefully expect to see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 642 mission is currently scheduled for Friday 22nd at 11:55pm UTC or 7:55pm EST. Related to the CRS launch coming up, SpaceX posted some pictures of the Dragon capsule. They said Dragon 2 vertical on Pad 40 for the first time. Related to Pad 40, SpaceX posted this video saying teams test the new emergency chutes from the Pad 40 crew tower in Florida. SpaceX has started selling its Starlink laser link tech to other companies. This article says SpaceX has started selling satellite lasers which are used for speedy in-space communications to other satellite firms, company president Gwynne Shotwell said at a conference on Tuesday. Looks like SpaceX is going to get a whole bunch more launches from the EU. This article says the European Union on Tuesday signed off on terms of a security deal with the United States that will allow it to pay SpaceX to launch its satellites. Heading to Boca Chica, work continues on the orbital mount after the launch. The Raptor maintenance platform was moved over to the launch site. Concrete was seen being poured near the orbital tank farm. Here's a look at the work on the new parking garage. Of course, the work on Star Factory's expansion is also continuing. Here's a look at the many Launch Tower 2 sections under construction at Starbase. There was a post with some information from Gwynne Shotwell on when we could expect to see Starship Flight 4. It says on a panel at the satellite conference, Gwynne Shotwell says SpaceX should be ready to fly Starship again in about 6 weeks. Says teams are still reviewing the data from the last flight and that Flight 4 would not have satellites on board. There was another post outlining the goals that SpaceX wants to achieve with Starship this year. It says she adds that the goal for Starship this year is to reach orbit, deploy satellites and recover both stages, and of course to launch Falcon 9 148 times. Related to the 6-week timeline, Musk said that's if everything goes right, but certainly possible. There was news posted about the FAA wanting to support SpaceX in trying to achieve this increased launch cadence. This post says FAA's Associate Administrator for Commercial Space Transportation says they are working with SpaceX to get them faster approvals for Starship launches. We want to get away from the launch-by-launch approvals and get more into what Part 450 was really designed for, which is an approval of a portfolio of launches. As always, I have to say thanks to Jack Beyer and Sean Doherty for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.